Okay, today we are going to see the Boolean algebra and its theorem. You already know normal algebra, which you are doing in your schools. Okay, now we are going to see Boolean algebra. So here this is mainly concerned with the number hours, ones and twos. Okay, one zeros and ones. Now we'll see it is formed by a scientist called Boolean. So it's named after him, Boolean algebra. And the rules and regulations of a Boolean algebra. So Boolean algebra is the category of algebra in which the variable values are the truth values, which means true and false. As I said, 0 or 1, 1 or 0. That's why. And you can say otherwise as true or false, ordinarily denoted 1 and 0 respectively. So Boolean variables, they are defined as variable or a symbol. The one which hold these values are called as Boolean variable. Normally in our other system also, x equal to y plus z, like that you will write. So where x, y, z, they are all variables and they can have different values. Say for example, y can have 9, z can have 10. So y plus z means 9 plus 10, that will be stored in x. That is why they are all called variables. They can hold the values. Okay, intermediate values we will always store in variables. Okay, so that is the concept of a variable. A variable is used to store the value. Simple. Here, Boolean variables, the same thing. Only thing is y and z will have either a 0 or 1. That's all. So they and x will be the added value of those two. So Boolean defined as a variable or a symbol defined as variable or a, sorry, this is occurring to second double times. Okay, generally an alphabet represents the logical quantities such as 0 or 1. And now I am going to introduce some terms. Already we have seen Boolean variables, and then we'll see another important term, truth table. This is a truth table. So what do you mean by a truth table? It is nothing but it looks like this, a table where you will be putting the variables. This is a table where you will be entering the variables. A is a variable, B is a variable. Then A multiply B. A dot B means A multiply B. Okay, A and B we will say. Then OR operation, A variable, B variable. Then these two together, addition, A plus B. And that we call it as OR. When you put a dot, you call it as AND operation. When you put a plus, then addition, then we call it as an OR operation. Then NOT operation, that is negation. Negation means the opposite. Okay, if it is 0, then 1, inverse. That we call it as a NOT operation. So these are all the very basic things which you should know before moving towards the Boolean algebra. Okay, these are all the terms which you are going to come across again and again. That is why I'm explaining all these things. So a truth table is a table that gives all the possible values of logical variables and the combination of the variables. So what do you mean by combinations? All the possible values. So for example, if you take this truth table, here we have, it has two variables, okay, A and B. Then A multiply by B, that A into B, which we call it as AND, okay. A and B, like that you can say. So this you call it as conjunction. When you say conjunction, it also means AND. AND means also AND. So both together say it is a multiplication. Then disjunction or operation. So disjunction or both mean the same thing. Then not means negation. Negation is opposite, inverse. Okay, so these are all the main terms which you should know. Now when I say what is the possible values, so for example, A can have a 0 or 1, B can have a 0 or 1. When both together, you can have 4 different combinations. So for example, when A can be a 0, B can be 0. This is one combination. Then A can be 0, at that time B can be 1. This is another combination. Then A can be 1 and B can be 0. This is another combination. Then A and B both are 1, that can be another combination. That is why which you can represent as 2 power. Since there are 2 variables, you can represent them as 2 power 2. Because this is a Boolean, right? So, 1 minute. Now, if you say, when I say 2 power 2, when I say 2 power 2, 2 is the boolean. That is, we are taking care of binary operations. All these things we are going to study about the binary operations. So binary means base is 2. This represents the variable. Okay, so when I say 2 variables, which is nothing but calculate it. 2 power 2, this is a variable and this is a base. So 2 power 2 means 4. So 4 different combinations for 2 variables. That is the meaning. If it is 3, 2 power 3 means 3 variables. So totally 2 into 2 into 2, it is 8. 8 different combinations for 3 variables. That's the meaning. Okay, so here A, B, we have all these combinations. And A multiply by B, you have to take it as an AND operation. AND is multiplication. So when you say 0 into 0, you have 0. 0 into 1, you have 0. Because anything by 0, you know it is multiplication is 0. Same way, 1 into 0, you have 0. So when both the variables are true, that means when both the value in the variables are 1 or true, then the value here also, it will be true or 1. See, I will be saying interchangeably true and 1. True is equal to 1, whereas false equal to 0. Okay, now OR operation. Here this is for addition. Now the same combinations, you can see the same combinations. How you have to do is 0, 0 is equal to 0. 0, 1, you change the last variable. Okay, mostly we will change from left, right to left. So this represents in numerical sense 1. This represents in numerical sense 0. 0, 1 and 2 and 3. So 0 to 3, which is nothing but 4 different combinations. So 1, 0 means it is equal to 2 and 1, 1 is equal to 3. Okay. So here when you say add 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1. So it is 1, 1 plus 0, it is 1 and 1 plus 1 is 1. Okay, it is not 2. It is 1 plus 1 is again 1 because it is a binary. So if you can say it as a true plus true will give you true value. Then comes the NOT operations, that is negation. So here, as I already told you, it will be the complement. So A, there is only one variable. So 2 power 1 is equal to 2 only. So only 2 different combinations only you can have, not 4 combinations just like here. So A will have either a 0 or a 1. So if A is 0, negation is 1. If it is 1, it will be 0. So like this, you have to write the truth table. And this is the basic truth table, which involves the AND operation, disjunction and negation. Now, when you go to laws of Boolean algebra, in general, we will study these following laws. That is commutative law, associative law, distributive law, identity law, redundance law, and De Morgan's law. We'll see one by one law. Okay, today we will see the commutative, associative law, and distributive. Now, commutative law. So what is commutative law? It says like that, A into B is equal to B dot A. So you can write A dot B as well as B dot A. Both are same. Okay, if you change the position also, it will not give you different answer. It is same. So this is commutative law. Same way here, A plus B means you can write it as B plus A. Girls, you must remember all these law, because when you are going to solve the Boolean algebra, you will be quoting these laws and then you will be reducing the equations. So you must remember, you should follow what I am taking. Is it clear? Then associative law. So associative law is this, A dot B. Everything is related with the dot and plus symbol. Okay. This is dot is for AND operation, plus is for OR operation. Plus there will be negation. But here we don't have negation. We completely talk about the AND. So when it is an AND operation, that is the conjunction, what will be the associative law? So A dot B within bracket dot C, it is equal to, if you write A outside, dot B into C. So it will be left hand side equal to right hand side. It will give the same result. That's what the meaning of this. Then A plus B plus C. Again, when you write A outside, then plus B plus C within the bracket. You have to write like this. Both are, so both answer will be the same. It will give the same result. So that's what associative law. Then distributive law. A within bracket. So here you have multiplication as well as addition. Okay, so A multiplied by B plus C. This can be written like this, what? A into B plus A into C. So here again, left hand side equal to right hand side. This everything you have to prove. We'll tell you, I'll tell you how to prove it. Okay, then A plus BC. This is another distributive law. A plus BC is A plus B dot, that is multiplication, A plus C. Okay. Any doubt so far?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay, girls. Now, this law, idempotent law, that is A plus A equal to A. Why it is A plus A equal to A? Because each time you have to remember it will have true and false value. Okay. So, A is 1 and A is 1 means 1 plus 1, it is 1 only, which is nothing but A. Okay, so 0 plus 0 is again a 0. Then multiplication, A dot A, 1 into 1, it is A. Now you can see the law which is given here, 1 into 1, 1, adhe mari inge 1 plus 1, A, 1. Okay, so this is what we say it as when both are having the same value. Okay, when both A, here 1 means here is also 1, right? So when both are having, they will give the answer A itself. So then redundance law, A plus AB equal to A. This is another law which you have to remember. Then A plus B, again it will give you A. So all these things we will be, these are all the rules. This you will be using in your equation, reduction of equations. I'll tell you what is reduction of equations when it comes. Null law, 0 plus A is less because it is a plus symbol. Okay, so you have A. 0 dot A means 0 because you are multiplying it by 0. So it is 0. Then identity law, 1 plus A to equal to 1. Why it is equal to 1? A may be here, A variable is given, whereas here the value itself is given. So in A, it may be a 0, it may be a 1. Whereas it is contrast to here. Here if it is 1, here also 1. So it is 1. Here if it is 0, here also it is 0, so answer is 0. But here it is different. 1, it is already given 1. So 1 plus 0 is also equal to 1. 1 plus 1 is also equal to 1. So that is why here we have written 1. Then 1 dot A. Here it depends upon the value of A. If A is 1, then 1 into 1 will be 1. If A is 0, then 1 into 0 will be 0, which is nothing but the value of A. So this also you should remember. Then negation law. A bar, negation, you can write it like this. In the previous case, we have seen negation like this symbol. But when it comes to equation, when you are writing it in equation, you can quote like this, A bar, or another one you can write like this also. See here. You can quote like this. A, mele vandu oru comma. So, indha maari irundhalo, you can say it as A bar. Negation, A bar, then like this. All are same. But normally we don't use that in the munadi paatha only a negation symbol. This we don't. Just in a truth table or a starting point, I am explaining you. But ingiyume ni A bar kudukalam. Illana A comma and the apostrophe kudukalam. Okay, like this you can press. So adhuk equal dhaan idhu. A bar plus A. A bar is complement of A. Ipa A vandhu inga 1 na, inga vandhu enna irukum? 0 irukum. So anyway, here it 1 is that. So 1 plus 0, it is 1. Suppose A bar 1 irundhudunu vechukonga. A enna va irukum? 0 va irukum. Inge 0 va irundhana inge 1. Inge 1 a irundhudunu inge 0. But anyway, edho oru edathila 1 irukku. So that plus equal to 1. Since it is an addition law. Okay, whereas inge pathina inge 1 irundhudunu inge 0 irukum. Inge 0 irundhudunu inge 1 irukum. But anyway, at any point of time, it has a value 0. So when you multiply it, you will have 0. Now, De Morgan's theorem. The next one is De Morgan's theorem. This we are going to prove A plus B, the whole bar, equal to இங்க வந்து addition okay with negation இங்க என்ன வரணும்னா a bar dot b bar separately okay இதுக்கு தனி bar இதுக்கு தனி bar then a b இதே மாதிரி and operation a dot b the whole bar equal to a bar plus b bar இதோட reverse sign இது ரைட்டா so this also you should remember then double negation ஏற்கனவே ஒரு காம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் அந்த மறுபடியும் அதை காம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் பண்ணா என்ன வரும் ஏவே தான் வரும் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஏ வந்து ஜீரோன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க ஜீரோவோட காம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் என்ன ஒன்னு ஒன்னோட காம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் என்ன ஜீரோ ஸோ இட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு அவர் ஏ ஸோ ஏ டபுள் பார் ஈக்குவல் டு த ஏ இட்ஸ் நவ் ஓகே பிஃபோர் கோயிங் த்ரூ வில் சி ஐ ஹவ் ரிட்டன் த லாஜிக்கல் கேட்ஸ் பட் பிஃபோர் கோயிங் த்ரூ தட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐ வில் கிவ் யூ அ ஸ்மால் இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன் டு லாஜிக்கல் கேட்ஸ் தென் வி கம் ஹியர் அகைன்